Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by MrExcel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1889, screen clipping tool for perfect Excel charts to PowerPoint. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, today's question, sent in by Marilyn. Marilyn wanted to know how to get her charts from Excel to PowerPoint and have them look right. And while there's lots of different ways to do this with copy and paste, it's easier, I know, in Excel 2010, I want to talk about an amazing tool today called the screen clipping tool. Now, this was introduced in Excel, starting in Excel 2010. It's here on the Insert tab, screen clipping right here. Actually, it says take a screenshot. And when we open this, what they do is they offer to insert a screenshot of the entire window of the other open applications, which is not the good thing. The good thing is this item down here at the bottom called screen clipping. And in fact, it's so good that on all of my computers, I've right-clicked and say, add to quick access toolbar, so that way I can get access to screen clipping all the time. I have it in both Excel and PowerPoint and Word. So here's the way that it's going to work. I'm going to make this chart look a little bit cleaner by turning off the grid lines in the sheets, so that way I have just a nice, perfect chart there. I'm going to go back to my PowerPoint slide. This is where I want that chart to appear. It's really important that PowerPoint is the active application and Excel is the most recent active application, because when I click insert screen clipping, PowerPoint's going to hide and what I'm going to see is what's left behind. And did you see where it just kind of grayed out there? Now that it's grayed out, I can take my mouse cursor and ungray out something. So in other words, I draw a rectangle. This is the part that I want to bring back to Excel or to PowerPoint or to Word. And it will bring an exact screenshot of that data. Don't have to worry about the colors changing. Don't have to worry about someone being able to double click the chart and see all the data. It's just a nice, perfect screenshot. This works great pulling data from web pages, pulling data from anything. You know, if you need a picture of something in Excel, you can use the screen clipping tool. I understand there's lots of other ways to get Excel data into PowerPoint. But again, as I mentioned, you know, if you don't do it right, someone has access to the whole workbook or the workbook is linked and it's all really complicated. This just always works. Now, if the data back here changes, well, then of course the picture doesn't change. All right, it's just a static a snapshot of the data, but a great way to go. I met Marilyn at one of my Excel seminars down in Florida. She, you know, said she was having problems with it. I said, you know, the screen clipping tool, if you're in Excel 2010 or newer, is just a great thing. Unfortunately, you know, what they've done here with insert screenshot is, you know, they make it seem like you're supposed to take the entire active window. And that would be bad to take the entire Excel window. You get the ribbon and the whole bit, you know, then you have to use the crop tool. So for my money, the really good part of this is the little bit at the bottom with screen clipping. Well, hey, I want to thank Marilyn for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.